Students, baat kar rahe hain about the standard Ethernet, the first and the original form of Ethernet that was able to support data rates of up to 10 megabits per second. Students, मैंने आपको बताया था कि most of the standard Ethernet applications have now been replaced by the evolution technologies which support much better or higher data rate as compared to the standard Ethernet. But students, some of the features of standard Ethernet, they still remain in the current technologies. And the first one that we discussed was the connectionless nature and the unreliable nature of the Ethernet. Now, students, chalenge and we'll have a look at a frame format and the frame size of a standard Ethernet, and we maintain pretty much the same frame format in today's Ethernet technologies as well. Students, as you can see, there are seven different fields in an Ethernet frame. The first two fields that you're looking at, which are the preamble and the SFD, start frame delimiter, these are actually applied at the physical layer. And so these are not applied at the data link layer, but they are part of our Ethernet frame. So in the first field is the preamble. It consists of 7 bytes, as you can see, or 56 bits. It basically has got a pattern of alternating zeros and ones, and they are basically there to alert the receiving system of the coming Ethernet frame. Now, students, aapko maine bataya tha ki we need a pattern. The Ethernet frame, by nature, has got varying lengths of payload or varying lengths of data. And so we need some sort of synchronization, and to provide that synchronization, we have got these preamble bits that actually tell the receiver that the frame is coming, and because of this alert and a timing pulse that is contained in the pattern, the receiver is able to synchronize and the timing and is able to know that a new Ethernet frame is coming. So the second field that you've got is a SFD, or the start frame delimiter, and once again this field, which is, as you can see, it's 10 10 10 and 11. This field signals the beginning of the frame again. So SFD warns the destination that this is the last chance for synchronization. So we are actually trying for synchronization using the preamble, and then once again we have got a start frame delimiter that's actually doing the same thing. Now students, both of these fields, preamble and SFD, they are attached by the physical layer in the form of the physical layer header that goes in front of the Ethernet frame. So in the third field of 6 bytes is the destination address, 48 bits. And students, when you send the data on the Ethernet link, it is in the form of the broadcast. And we will talk about that. So when the receiving station, it looks at the frame that is coming its way and looks at the destination address. If the destination address belongs to that particular station, it will keep the frame. Otherwise, it will discard it. Students, then you've got source address. This field is also 6 bytes, as you can see, and it contains the link layer address or the physical address of the sender of that particular frame. Students, then you've got the type field, and this is meant to specify the 2 bytes only, specify the upper layer protocol. So for example, if this frame is carrying data which is IP data, then this type field will represent that. If this is, however, an ARP packet, address resolution protocol, this type field will have the type that specifies ARP in it. Students, if you've got OSPF, which is your open shortest path first protocol, we'll talk about that in computer networks, it's a routing protocol, then this type field will actually represent that. Students, then you've got the data field. The data field has got a minimum payload length of 46 bytes and the maximum payload length of 1500 bytes. So this is the size of the data. If the data is less than 46 bytes, then what we do is we employ a process which is called as padding, and we make sure that we have got at least 46 bits in there by adding some extra bits into this data or payload type. Students, the last field that we've got in this Ethernet frame is the CRC, the cyclic redundancy check, and it is a 4-byte field, and we have discussed the CRC extensively in the previous discussions, and it's basically there for the error detection. In this case, we use CRC 32. Now, students, before we leave this, we need to discuss the frame topic about frame length as well. And as you can see, we have got a minimum size of the Ethernet frame, which is the minimum size is 512 bits or 64 bytes. And out of that, we have got 18 bytes of header. The preamble, this header excludes preamble and SFD, but you have got destination address, source address, type, and CRC. So your minimum frame length is equal to 64 bytes minus 18 bytes, which is what I told you is equal to 46 bytes. And students, the reason we have got this minimum length is because the CSMA CD, that works better if you have got a specific shortest possible length of the frame. And if we go below that, then we have issues with CSMA CD, and we'll talk about that. Students, now you've got the max length. Let me write on the top here. The max length is 1518 bits. And in this case, we have got to subtract once again 18 bytes of header. So our max length in the case of Ethernet frame is equal to 1518 minus 18, and that is equal to 1500 bytes. And students, the reason we specified this max length of the frame was because the memory back in the days of standard Ethernet was very expensive, and therefore the buffer size was very important. And to reduce that buffer size and to reduce the overall cost of the memory in the Ethernet frames, we kept the maximum size of the Ethernet frame, the payload size, to 1500 bytes, excluding the header. Students, another reason we specified this maximum size was to avoid any particular station from monopolizing the actual link. If, for example, we have got an unlimited size on this, then one station can keep on transmitting and every other station can keep on sensing the link and will find it busy and won't be able to transmit. So one station can monopolize the link. So we specified 1500 bytes to, number one, reduce the cost in the form of memory, and number two, to avoid from one particular station to monopolize the link.